opportunity each year to highlight some of the great work that's being done by individuals in this community for you. As someone who grew up in East Hartford, there's been a long tradition of citizens, coaches, volunteers, professionals, parents, people who have gone above and beyond who have had a lasting impact on generations of East Hartford youth. We are also going to celebrate the work of Regina Morrell, the Executive Director of the Circle of Life, and all that she has done for the East Hartford community. For the past 17 years, she has taught dance to youth from preschool through high school, and she's been involved in community advocacy for many years for youth as a member of the local East Hartford Child Plan and the East Hartford Local Prevention Council. So let me thank you for coming and supporting the youth in our community who stand up to be leaders, but also the leaders in this community who stand up for East Hartford youth. So welcome. And I think we will start with special recognition for Reggie Morrell. About 17 years ago, at an age when most people are thinking about slowing down or, you know, trying to find a quiet place to retire, for Reggie, this was her time to give back to the community through her love of dance, when she started the nonprofit Circle of Life Arts for All. And the Circle of Life mission states that they are committed to the quality of life for individuals and families through participation and access to the arts, regardless of age, ethnic background, or economic status. Our belief that arts provide a basic holistic need of the human mind, the body, and spirit, which enables each of us to lead a rich, full life and be productive members of the community. And for 17 years, the Circle of Life really worked on that mission. Over the years, they've done outreach programs in the school. They've reached out, targeted children as young as 3 and 4 year olds, and even students with special needs. She's also done youth development programming such as Dance Your Way to Success, love that title, lots of after school programming, and working with Manny Silva's Daycare Learning Center, a lot of programming for kids as young as 2 and 3 who've been able to be up here and perform. And also with senior citizens. She usually has a Friday dance, but one of the other programs she had were the seniors who were mentoring the younger students, the younger high school students. And Reggie has also been involved in a lot of community work over the years, including East Hartford Child Plan, the local prevention council, and we thought that this would be the place to recognize her special gifts to the community, because she was also a core contributor to the beginning of Prevention Idol. There have been many people who walked through the doors of the Circle of Life who've learned to dance, learned to work as a team, learned to find new ways to communicate, and learned through the arts, the ways that arts can enhance their lives. And for 17 years, Reggie has made that happen for many in East Hartford, and we would like to thank her for her efforts. At this time, I'd like to call up the mayor of East Hartford, Marsha LeClaire.
Say good evening, everyone. I'm absolutely honored to be here today, and so exciting not only to see the students that I know and students that I don't know who are so impassioned and here to represent themselves and talk about what it is to be drug-free and to support that message in their lives and throughout the community of East Hartford in which they attend school. I'm honored to be here today to talk a little bit about Reggie Morrell and what she's done for the town of East Hartford to recognize her years of service, long before she and Judge Brawl even started to do the Dancing with a Circle of Life and the teaching. They were embedded in the community, working hard for the benefit of our total community. Her husband was committed to the Rotary, along with many other organizations in town. And Reggie and Herb were always side by side, and they were kindred spirits in believing that whatever they could do to grow our community, to bring people together, to grow a community in the sense of knowing that one hand helps another, and you never ever know how important that hand can be. Over the years, my daughter graduated from East Harvard High School, but she was one of the first classes that Reggie taught to learn ballroom dancing for the senior citizens prom. And I remember how excited she was to take those ballroom dancing classes and to touch the lives of someone, a senior in the community, through an event that really was part of a historic, looking back now, on how much Rotary was able to connect with the talents of the Brawls and really to think forward about how they could touch another life. So Reggie, I remember very dearly what you had done there, and so thank you very much, because I do know that the seniors would dress up in their finest clothes as if it was a prom. And it had a fine dinner that was also supported by Rotary and volunteers, so that was wonderful as well. And this year, Reggie closed the circle of life, and there is a void for what she has left. But she has touched so many hearts and brought the arts into the form of dancing. And for many students, she showed them a form of the arts that they can have with them forever. And I know that Reggie and her husband danced since the first time they met, and they danced continually throughout their lives together, and it brought them great joy, and they were able to share that joy. So today I'm reading a proclamation, presenting a proclamation to Reggie, and a proclamation is a wonderful opportunity for the town to put into words something that then gets filed in the town clerk's office and becomes a part of the history of our community. So it's not just a piece of paper, it's the richness and the history that will forever live in the archives of the town of East Hartford. So the proclamation reads, whereas Regina Baral, along with her husband Judge Herbert Baral, opened the nonprofit organization Circle of Life Arts for All in September of 2002 to help improve their community through the arts. And whereas she has worked tirelessly promoting events and raising money for Circle of Life Arts for All with programs such as April in Paris, tributes to Black History Month, and especially the Great Gatsby event. And whereas Reggie introduced children of all ages to the beauty, elegance, and poise of ballroom dancing with classes at Sylvia Youth of Today and all East Hartford schools. And whereas through the Circle of Life Arts for All, she has provided youth and young adults with powerful, enriching experiences, which for many have changed the course of their lives. Whereas for the past 10 years, Reggie has organized, contributed, and collaborated with East Hartford Youth Services, ERASE, East Hartford Middle School, and East Hartford High School to successfully hold East Hartford's Prevention Idol for middle and high schoolers to display their talents and give testimonials as to why they should be drug-free. Now, therefore, I am Marcia A. LeClaire, Mayor of the great town of East Hartford, and proud to join with all town employees and members of the community to wish Regina Baral a well-deserved, happy, healthy retirement and recognize all her accomplishments and contributions to our town. Congratulations, Reggie. I'm going to ask you to be the photographer. Cheers.
We also have something from our delegation, which consists of Representative Jeff Curry, Representative Jason Rojas, Representative Henry Jinga, and our newest member of our delegation, Senator Anwar. Be it hereby known to all that the Connecticut General Assembly hereby offers its sincerest congratulations to Reggie Barrall in recognition of her years of commitment to the residents of East Hartford community. And to thank you and your late husband, the Honorable Judge Herbert Barrall, for all of the joys of dance and the arts that you shared with everyone. Be it known to all that you made a difference for our families, and while many struggled to reach out to young people, you connected. May we all remember Circle of Life Arts for All, and we wish you a good and healthy retirement and happiness. The entire membership extends its very best wishes on this memorable occasion and expresses the hope for continued success. Given this day, the 4th day of May, 2019, at the State Capitol in Hartford, Connecticut. And we have one more thing. And hopefully, I don't know if anybody can see this, but this is from Department of Youth Services for Reggie Barrall, and thank you for your 17 years of service. And it's a great picture of her and Reggie dressed up for the Great Gatsby. So, come up for this. Today, but there are various pictures of Reggie and her dancing. So stay for that. That would be great. So with that, why don't we move on to the talents and the kids. Thank you.
Yeah.
Citation he'd like to present to you.
perform as well, but I think it's better if I just say a few words. Your public health work is amazing, and the more I learn about it, I'm also a public health enthusiast, if you will. And then I did not consider myself a physician till I felt that I had completed my training in public health. And that's one of the best ways to make a difference, and the return on investment of the time is highest for this. So, this is from our entire delegation. All of our members, you know our members from East Hartford, and this is in recognition for all the work that you have done. Rather than reading it, I'll just say a few words and the thoughts. The difference that you've made in the lives of so many people is something that we as a community and the people of East Hartford are blessed with, and we cannot thank you enough for your work. And this is from the entire General Assembly on behalf of the entire General Assembly. I'm here to honor to present this to you. If you would want to come up here.
Mountain. Good evening, everyone. My name is Mr. Jason Hernandez. Today we come from United Taekwondo right on Burnside Avenue, right by the police station across from Dollar Tree. So we came to demonstrate some Taekwondo today. Our grandmaster was the founder of our school in 90. He brought the school into the United States in 1974, and it's been passed down from to our master right now, Mr. Reese. And today we're going to show a little bit of demonstration today. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Keandre Woods, and I'm performing. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Chloe, and I'm from the East River High School.
Hi everyone, my name is Emily Lanton and I go to East Hartford High School. that the physical things defy what's within. Oh, I've been there before, but that life supports so all the superficial.
Hi, my name is Dazlyn Towns, and I attend to East Harper High School.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. How are you all tonight? Good, great. Wanted to just say hello and introduce ourselves real quick. My name is Wilona Omwaku. I'm actually the founder and creator of the Arts for Change program. You all don't know this, but I'm actually a product of East Hartford. I grew up in East Hartford, went to Langford Elementary, East Hartford Middle School, and East Hartford High School. And I'm proud to say that I am a licensed social worker.
Hi, my name is Darian Arriaga, and I am from Journalism and Media Academy.
beautiful.
Make sure you do the votes and then come back.
Bring me the votes, please.